Hey guys, behind me is my MIG welder. It's a flux core MIG welder. It is actually not MIG, but it's a flux core. I bought this a few years ago, and I did a modification to modify it from AC to DC. So what I did is I modified this with a very simple modification using a bridge rectifier, and it's been working really good. I'm going to show you some of the sample weldings that I've been using for practices and things like that. But I'm going to show you how I did it, and hopefully somebody can benefit from it. So I've had this welder for a few years. It's been sitting in the shelf. I haven't really used it much. I used it maybe 3-4 times. But when I first bought it, it was creating a lot of splash and inconsistent welding. I choose to do the easiest type of modification, and it gives me a very nice welding from there. I'm gonna share with you some of the practices that I've been using to practice this welder. This welder has been working really nice. It puts up a lot of power, though I think the wire feed that's in there right here is not really working well. It puts up too much wires sometimes, and I have to turn it down, all the way down. I don't know if it's a problem with this particular welder or the whole design is not good. You only have four settings on this, so you get four different power levels. You get the min and max on the lift button, and then you got the one and two. So min one would be the lowest, and then min two would be the second level, and then max one would be the third, and then max two would be the fourth. For me, to use it on a 110 15 amp breaker does not work on the level two and three, so it's probably better if you put it on a 20 amp breaker. You'd be able to use different levels, but in my opinion, for level one min would be sufficient for just simple projects. And I can show you some of the weld practices that I've done on this after the modification. You can see it's putting very solid welds. In my opinion, it's good enough for DIY stuff. I've been practicing my welding skills here, but it's putting really nice welds here compared to what I started with. So I'm gonna open it up and show you what I did to modify it from an AC to DC output. I'm gonna show you also how to know if it's an AC or a DC welder. So I put the welder on the workbench here to kind of show you how to take it apart. So basically you have five screws on each side for the panels to come out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one slides up like this and be able to remove the cover this way. So you don't need to remove the cover to do this operation here, but you remove the side and possibly the other side to give yourself more space. So I'm gonna remove one side, both sides, and I'll show you how to check for if it's putting up AC for the MIG or it's putting up DC, and I'll show you the difference before and after. So as you can see here, this is the modification that was done. I'm gonna use a flashlight to kind of make this a little bit better. So as you can see, what I did is actually this wire and this wire
they were connected directly to the output wires. This is the positive that goes for the, as you know, for a MIG welder, you need to have the positive as your ground clamp. And then the negative would be your gun, your MIG gun. So as you can see, what I did is I cut the wires that were coming out of the transformer, both of them, and then I did the modification. So in order for you to do the modification, you need to get this rectifier. The one I bought here is a 250 amp rectifier. I wanted to oversize it to make sure it doesn't overheat and allows me to put the full 130 amp on the machine without blowing up the diode. So close up here, so as you can see, so I basically cut the wires that are coming from the transformer, this one and this one, and they were putting up AC, so you couldn't tell which one is the positive, which one is the negative. So what I did is, as you can see, this transformer is just a pure transformer. There's nothing really to filter the current, the voltage that's going out. So I cut those, split them into two halves. So one half is here and the other half is here. And then the other wire that's coming out of the transformer, I cut it, also split it. And then I bought those lugs. Those lugs, you can buy them from Home Depot. They allow you to transform the wire from just a wire lug into a screw type lug. So you can see, those ones I bought from Home Depot. I bought four of them. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And there's enough space in the bottom here to slide this thing down, and then they screw it. So if I flip this, I'll show you the bottom side where it got screwed. So as you can see, four screws here that show, that connect the diode rectifier into the bottom of this. And that also serves as a heat sink. So when you connect this to the bottom, I also shaved a little bit of the paint from the bottom of this to allow me to get a better contact and better heat sink between the rectifier and use the body as a heat sink as well. So I'm going to turn it on now. I'm going to, of course, put safety gloves before I take measurements. And I'll show you the output that's coming here versus the output that's coming into the welding cables. Okay, I opened the other side of the welder just to show a little bit more clarity from the other side. As you can see, if I can zoom in, and this rectifier is sitting right here. And then you have the four lugs, 1, 2, and then the 3 and 4 and the others in the back side. So I'm gonna do the measurements and I'll show you the difference before and after. So in order to do that, I got my trusted avometer here. So I had this for a long time and it's been very trusted device. So I'm gonna put it on DC volt. I'm gonna show you how this thing is not actually putting any DC voltage, because once you try to measure it with a DC, it's not gonna measure anything. So let's go through this. I'm gonna plug it and then we'll show you. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on and I'll show you what I mean. So you may not hear me well because of the fan, but I'm gonna try to explain what I'm doing here. So I'm gonna measure the output between both legs right here. And I hope you're able to see my measurement. I'm gonna put it here. So this is set for DC right now. So when it measures right now, it's measuring nothing. I'm gonna put between both connectors that are coming out of So as you see, it's not measuring anything. I'm right now connected to both terminals, both sides, one from this side and one from the other side, and I'm not getting anything. I'm gonna put it on AC, and you're gonna see the voltage that's coming out. So right now it's putting 28 volts, which is the normal according to the manufacturer. This is the AC measurement. I'm gonna switch it to DC again to show you that it's not putting DC. So showing millivolts and it fluctuates, that tells you that it's not actually a DC. So this machine is putting 28 volts AC, and that's why it was really welding. The weld quality was not good, and it was putting a lot of sparks. So now I'm gonna measure it, measure the other side after the rectifier, putting the DC back, and it will tell you what we're getting. So right now we're getting 30 volts DC. This is it's showing negative DC because I am putting the negative on the positive side. So I'm gonna switch those. So this is my positive, which is supposed to be the ground clamp, and then the negative is connected to this one. So I'm getting 30 volts DC coming out of this thing. No need to put any capacitors, nothing. It works really nice, and it's been working for my weld practices and my little DIY projects. So just wanted to share this quick video with all of you to show you how I did it, and hopefully somebody will benefit from it. Thank you. And if you like my video, please subscribe and like the video. I'm planning to put a lot more videos from my DIY projects, including my solar system that I just installed in my vacation home, and some other modifications that I did on my generators. So stay tuned for more, and let me know if you have any questions or you like get a little bit more information. I'm gonna leave the link for the diode, the rectifier in the link in the description. And if you guys are interested, you can get the same one. So this is in summary how I did it. And if you like what you saw, please leave your comments and like and subscribe. I'd appreciate if you have any suggestions for future videos. Thank you.